A tooth abscess is a pocket of pus caused by an infection. It damages the tissues in your mouth and it can spread to other areas of your body, causing serious health issues in some cases. Now, an abscess tooth won't heal on its own and it needs treatment from a dentist, so it's really important you don't ignore it. In this video, we're going to cover different types of dental abscesses, risk factors, symptoms, causes, diagnosis, treatment of dental abscesses, as well as outlook. So let's start off by understanding what a dental or tooth abscess is. Well, a tooth abscess is a pocket of pus from a bacterial infection in your gums, and it usually looks like a red, swollen bump, boil, or pimple. It affects the involved tooth, but the infection can also spread to surrounding bone and neighbouring teeth. Now, abscesses can occur in different places around a tooth for different reasons. Now, just to provide you with slightly more detail, three different types of tooth infections can cause abscesses. Now, the first is an infection that develops in your gums. It doesn't usually affect your tooth or surrounding supporting structures. The second is something called a periapical abscess. Now, this is an infection that forms at the tip of your tooth root. If you've got a tooth that's decayed, fractured, or damaged, bacteria can enter your tooth and spread to the pulp, which is the innermost part of the tooth that contains the nerves and the blood vessels. Now, when bacteria invade the pulp, infection can spread from the tip of your tooth's root and eventually to the surrounding bone, causing an abscess to form. Finally, periodontal. Now, this infection starts in the bone and tissues that support your teeth. A periodontal abscess usually results from gum disease, and it's more common amongst adults. Now, if it's left untreated, a tooth abscess can spread to your jawbone, the soft tissues of your face and your neck, as well as beyond. In extremely rare cases, the infection can also travel to your heart, causing a condition called endocarditis, as well as brain, causing bacterial meningitis. So it's really important that if you think you have an abscess, you need to seek help from your dentist. So now we know a little bit more about what a tooth abscess is. Well, who gets abscessed teeth or who is most at risk for them? Well, you're most likely to develop an abscessed tooth if you smoke, and people who smoke are about twice as likely to get tooth abscesses as people who don't. Also, if you have a dry mouth, and that's because bacteria tend to thrive in a mouth with low amounts of saliva. Also, if you've got poor general oral hygiene. Now, to help this, regularly brushing, flossing, and getting dental cleanings can help reduce the harmful bacteria. Or if you've got a weakened immune system, and that's because diseases or medications can lower your immune response, making it harder for your body to fight off the germs that can cause a dental abscess. So what are the symptoms of an abscessed tooth? Well, if you've got a tooth abscess, you'll more than likely have pain in your mouth or teeth. Now, you might describe the pain as annoying or throbbing pain, a sharp or shooting pain, continuous pain, or perhaps only when chewing, or radiating pain, which is pain that's going from the tooth to your jawbone, your neck, or even your ear. Now, other tooth abscess symptoms might include tooth sensitivity to hot or cold food or drinks, as well as temperatures, a bitter taste in your mouth, bad breath, which is medically known as halitosis, as well as gum redness and swelling, or perhaps loosening of the affected tooth, as well as a swollen area in your upper or lower jaw. Now, in some cases, an open, draining sore on the side of your gums can form, and if this is the case, you obviously need to go and see your dentist. Now, in addition, you might experience more generalized symptoms around the body, so things like a high fever, so a temperature greater than 37.5 degrees C or 100.4 Fahrenheit, swollen lymph nodes, and you might notice these around the jaw area, as well as general discomfort, uneasiness, or just feeling very unwell. So what causes a tooth abscess? Well, anything that creates an opening for bacteria to get into your tooth or the surrounding tissues can lead to a tooth abscess forming. For example, you might have a decaying tooth, medically known as a cavity. This is where the hard surface of your tooth starts to decay, and this occurs when bacteria break down sugars in food and drink, creating acid that attacks the enamel. Bacteria could also get in through broken, chipped, or cracked teeth or through your gums. So now we've covered the symptoms and causes of dental abscesses, well, how is an abscessed tooth diagnosed? Well, your dentist will start to ask you about your symptoms and they'll examine your teeth. This might mean that they will tap and press on your teeth, and the reason that they're doing this is because a tooth with an abscess is often more sensitive to touch or pressure. In addition to examining the tooth and the surrounding tissue for signs of infection, your dentist might order an x-ray of your teeth, and this is to look for disease. Now, your dentist can also use the x-rays to determine if the infection has spread to other parts of the mouth, so for example, the jawbone, and it might be affecting other areas. Now, if the infection has spread to other areas, for example, within your neck, the dentist might request a scan, which is called a CT scan, which will help identify the extent of the infection. And this is just a slightly more detailed scan than the x-rays. So now let's move on and cover management and treatment of a dental abscess. And there are several different options that we can discuss here. Now, the primary goal of treatment is to eliminate the infection and prevent complications from arising. Now, there are lots of different options for treatment, and your dentist should advise you on the one that they think is best for you. And it's best doing this by having a discussion with them and asking them questions and things that you're concerned about. Now, the first option that they might discuss is something called incision and drainage. This is basically where your dentist makes a small incision or cut in the abscess to drain the pus. They might also place a small rubber drain there, and this is to help keep the area open so the rest of the infection can drain out, because you don't want the pus sitting there. The next option is something called a root canal, and the aim here is to eliminate the infection and save your tooth. Now, this involves removing your tooth's infected pulp and filling the space with material to prevent another infection. Now, the pulp's important when the tooth is growing, but once it's mature, the tooth can survive without the pulp. Now, after the procedure, your tooth should go back to normal relatively soon. Finally, sometimes an abscess tooth unfortunately becomes damaged beyond repair. In these cases, your dentist might need to remove your tooth completely. You'll also likely be started on antibiotic medication that you'll need to take for a few days. And again, this is trying to eliminate the infection that's occurring in your mouth. Now, many people ask, how soon after tooth abscess treatment will I feel better? Well, a tooth abscess should clear up soon after treatment. Temporary sensitivity is common, and it might take a few days to feel completely back to normal. Now, because every case is unique and healing times vary from individual to individual, you should ask your dentist what to expect after your tooth abscess treatment for you. Importantly, a tooth abscess won't go away on its own. Now, the pain might temporarily stop if the infection causes the pulp inside your tooth to die. The pain stops because the nerve isn't functioning anymore, so you might not be able to feel it, but the bacteria will continue to spread and destroy the surrounding tissue. So if you have a tooth abscess that has symptoms, see your dentist even if you no longer have pain. I hope you found the video useful and informative. I've included lots of extra links in the description box of this video from trustworthy websites, so things like the NHS website in the UK and the Mayo Clinic in the US. And if you've got any questions, please do post them in the comment section below and I'll get back to you. Thanks for watching, and until next time, bye.